Well, here we are out in the middle of the lake. Just turned on the spot connect. Tracking should be working. March 10th, I think it is. Gonna go up for a ride towards Eagle Lake on the snowmobiles. Pretty nice out, pretty windy out here in the middle of the lake though, but that's minor. We'll be off the lake pretty soon. Oh, there's somebody coming. Using the Hero 2 today. Where's this guy going? Cruiser, that's a cruiser. So yeah, onwards we go. Stay tuned. Just cruising along. Coming into Contact Bay. Pretty drifty after that snow we got yesterday. Groomer hasn't had a chance to get out yet. Freaking rough. It's winter time now. What are you gonna do? Stopped here quickly at Contact Bay. Been up to here on the ATVs a few times. Nice camp spot here on the point. Lots of wood ticks around here though. Sunny day. Windy but sunny. Onwards we go. We don't know where, but we're going. The highway 502. Got a crossover. Looks like she's melting pretty good on there with all the salt. CK's through. Trails are pretty good. They just got that snow from yesterday on them. Bit loose in the corners. We're gonna cut across on that little trail where all the beaver dams were on the big grizzly and on the beaver dam through me there. See how that works, I guess. I think that's where the trail goes. Just up to the Door Lake Road here. Must have to go down here a little ways, but look at that's plowed, fresh. I guess we do. Just going through some of the beaver dams, I think. Looks different in winter. I don't know if that is that. Maybe. The damn beavers are sleeping now, I think. Well, I don't know if they sleep. Hanging out under the ice. Watching a little bit of the Nature Channel or something. Man, these things are loud. My ears are ringing. Trail's awesome, though. As you can see, I think this is some beaver dams here, maybe. Yeah. Definitely is. Looks like it's... The ice has sunk here. Too much weight, I guess. Now, I'm pretty sure this is the dam here where the grizzly threw me. Right here, I think. Right there. Looks quite a bit different in winter. Just coming up to the Bear Narrows Road. We've been up here many times in the summer. Oh, it's all nice and plowed too. CK's bearings seem to be working good. Just came through a curvy section through a swamp. Now where? I do not know. Follow the signs, I guess. This is headed towards Eagle Lake. That's as far as we're gonna go, I think. We've gone just about 15 miles already. Cover a lot of ground. on these babies. Quickly.
We're heading towards Eagle Lake and just came up to the Navish Lake Road. Been here lots in the summer. Oh, there's Cubbee. And we had some snow yesterday, so the trail's not groomed, but there's quite a few tracks, so I would imagine they headed out that way.
Really looks like they've cut a lot of wood down here since we were down here. I guess that was like a year and a half ago. Saw some fresh moose tracks back there, but no moose. No Bigfoots either, but who knows. Good trail though. Yeah, they've really cut a lot of wood in here. Christmas tree heaven right there. We're just coming on to Eagle Lake, big honking lake. We've been down here with a grizzly and turned around on the water here before. Right here. I don't think we're gonna go too much further. It's quite a ways to Vermilion Bay, I think. Not sure how far, but all on the lake. .7 miles to here. This is 19 and a half. I guess I must have been flying a bit. Well, we just had a little snack. Time to go back, I guess. Had to come up off the lake. That wind's really cold. It's not cold out, but the wind was really cold. So, yeah. Navish Lake Road. We just checked in with you guys on Facebook. Had a hard time getting a signal, but then it was pretty good, so I think we sent a picture up there. So yeah, 21 miles just about. Back to town we go, I guess. Oh.
Some funny tracks back there.
Oh, did you hear that? Tree knock.
So I think it's a good place for Cubbee to do some Squatch whoops. Let her rip.
I can't whoop under pressure.
Okay, I'll turn this way.
I've never really practiced before, so.
Over here, Mr. Bigfoot.
It
echoes.
Echo, eh?
Yeah.
Listen. You'd brown yourself if you heard something. Okay, we gotta get back underway. Just finished my Bigfoot whoops. CK's calling me Bobo now. Kind of look like him, I guess. Not. Onwards we go, Bobo. This going through this new section they made through the swamp here. It's pretty twisty. Kind of cool. A little tight, I suppose. Woohoo! Good place for a squatch and a moose to hang out here, but... Has any of you people watching there, you ever seen anything weird out in the bush? Well, other than your buddies, but, you know, anything. Sure, some people got some good stories. I don't know, but somebody's got a wicked set of skis on here. They just chew the corners right up. I wonder if it's those, maybe those dual runner ones or something. Look at, they make ditches here. Like furrows. Plant corn. Not that I know really how that's done, but... I think I got a plug going out on the old ZRT. She sputs a bit there at certain speed. Starting to foul the plug, I think, on this warm day. Maybe. Just coming up the Bear Narrows Road again here. Whoop. Stop. Throttle pumper. This is where we had parked the Titan that day when we were on that ride in the spring where the grizzly threw me. Coming in there and we parked it right here. Oh, snowmobile. Good timing, someone coming along. See any? Any Bigfoots? Oh, he's got a little sputter in his too. That guy's not friendly. Watch out for the Bigfoots, because I called them out and they'll be all on the trails waiting for you. Back at the highway. Geocache hidden in the bush over here somewhere. Or used to be, anyways. A few years ago, I imagine it's still there. And there. Have it on my GPS. So I'm not sure, but I think we might try to go over by mile and trap. Trail's not groomed because it's closed down now, but see how it goes. So yeah, I think we're gonna try to go this way. This used to be the A trail, but been closed for quite a few years. I think they groomed it. They were going to use it this year, but apparently they had trouble with the groomer going through a beaver dam, or I don't know what happened. Something. So I don't think it's been groomed for a while. Well, we're just coming up to the spring here. That's where we were sitting in the water. The fish came up to us. Okay, I got my GPS figured out. That is Trap Lake. Slushy here all the time because there's a spring right there and the water goes in there. That's where we were sitting in the water and the fish swam right up and the people were partying across the lake. Could go back home that way, but I don't know. Snow's pretty deep. Somebody did go there though. Some kind of a trail there, but anyways, I'll show you the spring over here. It's still green around there. I think I showed you before. Oh, is it evergreen? Look at that. That looks weird in the winter. Huh, cool. The water's over there, but pretty hard to... Oh no, it comes out right there out of that pipe. I don't know if you're gonna be able to... I don't want to fall in there. That'd be chilly. There's the pipe right there, but look at all the green stuff growing there. It's like Yellowstone. Cool. Well, I guess we should get going. Trap Lake. Spring water. 36 miles already, so time to go home to the puppies. We just checked on them. Oliver was watching the camera. Just coming back up the Contact Bay, the little campground here. I'm about to go back onto the lake. Wabagoon Lake. CK lost her saddlebag somewhere, so I guess we're going back to look for them. So rough, they flew right off, I guess. Well, I had to come back quite a few miles, but there they are. Ay, ay, ay. Caught them before anybody swiped them anyways. Someone's got a motor home out here. The ultimate ice fishing hut. On our way back home. So as we pull into our backyard here, guess that's gonna conclude our trip for today. Pretty good little ride. 56.6 miles, 53.2 on the GPS. That's about 85 kilometers or something, I'm guessing. And yeah, nice day. Hope you all enjoyed your trip, and a big thank you to all the new subscribers and likers of our Facebook page. Appreciate all your support, taking the time to stop in and visit us. So, yeah. Thanks for watching.